Just welcome in this second series of the lecture. And before the Supreme Court, what were the arguments of both the parties, number one, and number two, what was the lacuna in the decisions given by the labor court? This was the second. And third was, what is the law in favor of, whether in favor of the single party, that is the appellant, or in favor of the another party, that who is the respondent. That was the aspect before the Supreme Court. And Supreme Court have the power to interpret the words as well as to say that whether this decision which was given by the lower court or the court below the Supreme Court was correct according to the provision of law. And in this context, the Supreme Court has said that, because time is very limited, how I can admit the student. Now, the point is that before the Supreme Court, it requires the definition of the employee, because it has been whether a person has been given the resignation from the company will be treated as a employee still of the that company where he is no more, because he has given the resignation from that Coleman, Bienta Coleman company, and claiming after that, my claim, please give me my claims and gratuity, give me, and the compensation of all these things. These words has been interpreted by the Supreme Court in this case, and the Supreme Court finally said that, interpreted all these things, and the cases which had submitted for own favor in this matters, these were related to this, that in the first instance I have said. The first of all, the claim, and the claim, the Supreme Court laid down the principle that if a person's dues has been claimed by the employee when he has left that employment, left the parent employment, if suppose it has been left. Whether he will be treated as an employee. Supreme Court very categorically said, taking into consideration of various laws, that the due was not new. It was a due of that time when he was employee. It means employee includes, for the purpose of the definition, employee includes the ex-employees also. If any claims are there, he is an ex-employee. But it cannot be said after leaving any department, he has the whole relationship has been broken down or it has been disconnected. It cannot be said, because his name will not be the employee, but his name will be the ex-employee. Number one, new aspect has been given by the Supreme Court. He was the ex-employee of the Bienta Coleman company, number one. Number two, the issue relating to the applying of the estoppel on the respondent. The court said that the argument has placed by both the parties that the lump sum claim has been given to the respondent, that was the 2810, and he was in apprehension that if I shall not give the receipt to the company of this amount which has been related to the lump sum amount, it means that they will not accept, the company shall not accept my resignation, and if the resignation shall not be accepted, how I will join? That was the argument. How the respondent said that how I can join the another company, that was apprehension, because I have given the receipt. One new facts was there, the check he had received from the Bienta Coleman company, that was in the possession of that gentleman, because he has not neither the deposited for the clearance to the bank, or he has not withdrawn the cash. He has kept it in the possession, because after the certain period, the check automatically lapse. It means the amount which has received by the respondent has not been accepted, because received was given, but he has not deposited the check in the bank. It means partly he has not accepted that amount. It means estoppel cannot be applied in that matters. Number one was the apprehension, the facts were there, and number two was related to this matter, which says that the check was not cashed, not deposited, not credited, or neither it has been withdrawn by the respondent. Indirectly implied, he was in the opinion, or he was in the habit that I am not going to be accepted the amount which was given by the company because my other dues are also there. That was the facts in the case. The another point relating to the notice. 1 month notice was not given. And in the notice, there is one provision provided that if the employer will waive the notice, it can be waived. And the notice at the time of accepting the resignation of the respondent, the company has not raised this issue. Why you have not given that the notice? That was not raised by the company. If it is not raised by the company, then normally the company cannot take the plea and ground of that estoppel later on, because it has already waived by the company. Automatically, it has waived by the company. If the company has waived this notice, the company cannot say later on that he has not given the notice, that if the notice was not there, why you have accepted the resignation? Why you have not given the letter so-called to him? Give first the notice and then we will accept it. The company has immediately accepted. And secondly, lump sum amount has been given. The another argument of the company was there that there is no provision in the rules to give any compensation of the leave which is due. That one. The company was failed to submit the rule before the court. The company has not submitted before the that labor court. What is the rule? And said that there is no rule. If a employee is not there, then leave cannot be granted to him. But he was a ex-employee. And leave was due of that period when he was the employee. That was the point. The another aspect relating to this case was that the clarify the world wages, because the car allowance and the free calls has not been mentioned categorically in the definition of the 2EE. Then court said that there is world others, and what he has used the car and submitted the bill to the company for the payment, and at the same time he has used the telephone or submitted the bill to the company for the purpose of the work which he has done in the interest of the company. That is the point. For the purpose which he has work done in the interest of the company. That's why the company has paid that claims also of the earlier months. And now for calculating the gratuity, the company is making the argument that it will not come within the definition of the wages. That has not accepted by the court, because you have paid all these things, facility you have been given, and in the definition it has written the medical facility, it has written the health, it has written the food, and all the words are there, and one word is other than that. It comes under the other, because it was essential for performing the duty as a correspondent of the newspaper. Therefore, none of the argument has accepted by the Supreme Court, and Supreme Court has rejected all the arguments of the company, and finally it has decided in favor of the respondent. Not only this, one thing is very relevant, which I am going to be expressed. Please give the attention. that company has imposed the cost of the case also. The Supreme Court has imposed the cost of the case on the company. That has been imposed because of the reason. What was the reason? None of the argument has been proved by the company before the Supreme Court, and none of the issue has proved by the disproved by the company before the Supreme Court. Therefore, it was the gross case which was against the company. Single point has not been proved by supporting any law and relevant facts. That's why the court has imposed the cost of the case and dismissed the appeal which has filed by the company before the Supreme Court, and it was dismissed. Now, one point that is very essential, that in which circumstances court can impose the cost of the case on the another party who have lost the case before the court or in the court. The one principle which has laid down by the Supreme Court in this Bent Coleman Company 1970, page number of Supreme Court of 426, published in AIR, that in the matters when none of the argument or none of the issues shall be proved by any party before any court, then certainly court have the power to impose the cost. This is the principle. And the second principle, if you will search other cases, if the per incurium law has submitted before the court, the cost can be imposed. Court have the power not only to dismiss, but to impose the cost. And it is not a good system of losing any case. And case can be lost, of course, but at the same time, the cost, if imposed on the party, it is a worst of the argument and searching the law. Therefore, the very careful it requires to be of the party and especially of the advocate. Case filing is very easy, and reputation of the advocate is one of the very essential point which is related to the matters of the cases. And reputation before the court and reputation of the advocate in between the clients and the public. Therefore, it requires the hard work for searching the issues and making the argument in a way so that at least the party may say that I have done the lot of hard work to win and to decide the case. Thank you very much. This was the basically of the analysis of this Bent Coleman Company case. One of the another case that not required to discuss much about it, but there was the reference of the Section 5 and Section 17 of the 1955 Act. One case of recovery of this one says that, I will deliver the lecture on this act also. The Samarjit Ghosh versus Bent Coleman Company, another case. Samarjit Ghosh versus Bent Coleman Company Private Limited, 1987 case. It is a 1987 case of the Bent Coleman Company of another working journalist, that is the Samarjit Ghosh. And go through that judgment also and read it original case, and then make the points, argument, issue, relevant fact, and at the same time the law involving this case, and submit it by both the parties in for and against. It is the duty of the PG student to analyze. Very critical approach should be there. Critical approach and what are the good points, what are the bad points, what is the mistake, and what argument has been placed before the court. And if you will develop your habit to read the original cases, then there will not be any kind of problem wherever you will go. Even if in the practice, in job, in judiciary, in administration, in social work, in NGO, and wherever you will be there. But only one capacity should be of the student, to speak, please speak. That's why the seminar presentation, it has been just some student has been taken it very easily. But in the second semester, I am in position to think that the every student will present in a different manner, so that one can say that these are the student who have learned something by learning and by going in detail and deep of the course. Thank you very much. I'm not taking much your time, so because this is the morning time, but tomorrow I will take your class at the same time on the discussion of this act. One lecture I will deliver on it, and then I will move forward for the other discussion of the other component of the syllabus. Thank you once again.